Hi, my name is Michel Bierler, and I'm a professor at École Polytechnique Fédérale de Lausanne in Switzerland. We have prepared for you a series of three courses on optimization, where we will cover the main mathematical principles and some of the most important algorithms. I had the pleasure to prepare this course with Noor Dougui, Céline Attac, Stefano Bortolomiol, and Merichel Pacheco.
Consider this box and this marble. Thanks to gravity, the marble will be positioned on a precise spot, which happens to be the corner of the box. Mother Nature is actually solving a linear optimization problem, where the position of the marble is called the decision, the altitude of the marble is the objective function to be minimized, and the box represents the constraints. We will see how the geometry of the constraints plays an important role. We will introduce a mathematical analogy to the box called polyhedron. It will allow us to transfer geometric intuition into algorithmic ideas through linear algebra in order to find an optimal solution of the problem. You will learn how to formulate, transform an optimization problem, and characterize an optimal solution. You will learn how to represent the constraints of a linear optimization problem with a polyhedron. You will learn how to derive a companion problem called the dual. Finally, you will learn how to formally characterize an optimal solution and how to find it using an algorithm called the simplex method.
The pervasiveness of GPS navigation systems and online map services allows everybody to compute in a fraction of a second the fastest or the shortest itinerary between two points in a large, complex network. For instance, we can obtain a path between EPFL in Lausanne and Moscow in Russia. How does it work, given that the number of possible paths between these two distant locations is extremely large? This is an example of a network optimization problem. We will introduce a mathematical object that mimics the structure of a physical network. You will learn how the properties of this object allow to formulate an interesting class of optimization problems called the transshipment problem. We will then focus specifically on the shortest path problem. You will learn an efficient algorithm to solve this problem. The second part of the course on network optimization deals with discrete optimization, where the decision variables take only integer values. It typically happens when the decision is about a number of objects or a decision to perform an action or not. You will learn how to specify a discrete optimization problem. You will then be introduced to two algorithms to solve discrete optimization problems.
Switzerland is full of mountains that are full of skiers. Skiers follow a smooth path to reach the bottom of a mountain. Nonlinear optimization consists in exploiting the smoothness of a function to find a minimum or a maximum. The smoothness of the function allows to use its derivatives that provide information about the slope and the curvature of the function. You will learn how to exploit these derivatives to characterize optimal solutions and to design algorithms to solve them. In particular, you will learn how to use Newton's methods to solve nonlinear equations in the context of optimization. You will also learn a family of algorithms called descent methods. Finally, you will learn how the two are related.
During the course, we will suggest you to implement some algorithms to better understand how they work, using the programming language Python and an environment called Jupyter Notebook. If you're not familiar at all with Python and do not want to follow an introduction to Python, you can skip these exercises and look directly at the solution. The course has been designed based on the companion book Optimization, Principles and Algorithms, published in 2015 at EPFL Press. The online course is self-contained, and the book is not required to follow it.
Throughout the videos and the exercises, we have tried to combine mathematical rigor and intuition to allow a smooth understanding of the important concepts of optimization. Whichever one of the three courses you choose, we wish you a lot of fun taking it.